guys. So we just checked out of the M residence, which is a process. Anyway, we're currently in a tutu heading to the bus station, and then we have our 6 to 8 hours and preparing for 10 hours. A bus to Ho Chi Minh, so we're pretty excited. We have our visas this time, no problem, and they're for 30 days. Also, now that we only need it for like 4 days, but whatever. Be a fun time in Saigon / Ho Chi Minh, and yeah, we're looking forward to another one. That's right.
We're going back to Vietnam, baby.
Back to Vietnam. Currently 5 p.m., which means we have been on the road for 4 hours, and we haven't stopped at the border yet. So who knows if that's like halfway or after we are at the border, it's a short drive. I don't really know because I don't have service. Basically, I have no idea how long we have left on this bus. Luckily though, this is the nicest bus that we've ever been on, and the ride is great. It's not super bumpy or anything. There's no like intense braking like there was in Laos. So yeah, we're having a good time.
Morning from Ho Chi Minh City. So we made it in last night and we're at our Airbnb. We'll link this one below because this location is prime. We're actually staying on Backpacker Street. For now, we're going to the Reunification Palace and the War Remnants Museum. But before we head out for our day in Ho Chi Minh, we wanted to share our experience coming in yesterday because it was vastly different than our experience coming into Vietnam the first time. So if you guys remember, we came from Vientiane in Laos to Hanoi a few weeks ago, and it was honestly a nightmare. The Cao Treo land border crossing is just not as nice or built up, and we had to walk a kilometer in the rain, and we had to deal with really confusing instructions trying to get our passports stamped and our visas approved. And we had the issue where we were only allowed 14 days into the country, so that was a whole other story. Anyways, we paid $35 each yesterday for that bus ride from Phnom Penh to Ho Chi Minh City. And it is absolutely appalling how a little bit of extra money can make your experience 10 times better. Because yesterday we got on the bus and we had a lot of space in our seat. I could actually extend my legs fully. And I'm 5'8", so that's a pretty good amount of space to be given. And it was super punctual. They left on time. They didn't like wait around at the stops or have an hour long lunch break. It was really efficient. And then this is just the thing that was absolutely crazy to us, because we got to the Mok Bai land crossing and it was literally the easiest thing we've ever done in terms of immigration, because the company that we took, they took all of our passports and they gave them to the Cambodian immigration officers and they stamped us out. We didn't even talk to any officers. And then they also stamped us into Vietnam. We didn't talk to any officers coming into Vietnam. We didn't get our face scanned, our fingerprints, anything. It was VIP treatment and it was crazy.
We didn't even have to pay a stamping fee. Also, if you're a new viewer and you want to see our Laos border crossing into Vietnam, we'll link that up here to the right.
Anyways, we'll also leave the bus company's information down in the description below because we recommend you just pay to go on the little bit more expensive bus because they have private bus stations and they dropped us off right in the middle of the city center, not 30 minutes outside of the city. And so when we arrived, we only had a 3-minute walk from the bus station to our Airbnb. Okay, anyways, we need to go get food and then we're gonna start our adventure in Ho Chi Minh City.
Currently drawing out some more dong, but we have some extra Cambodian reals, just like $20 or something. And we went to 2 currency exchangers. They would not exchange real to dong. So that's interesting. I guess we'll hold on to it and maybe exchange it in an airport or something. We made it to the Reunification Palace here in Ho Chi Minh City. It's raining a little bit, but it's all good. This was formerly the presidential palace of South Vietnam. And this is just an iconic place because it marks the fall of South Vietnam in the Vietnam War. Behind us are the tanks that supposedly crashed through the gates here. And then Saigon fell once they captured this palace, and that marks the end of the Vietnam War. One interesting thing we heard about the palace is that it still looks like it did in the 1960s. They didn't renovate it or update it or change it or anything. So we'll literally be walking back through time, and that should be pretty cool to see. It's interesting to see the photos in the 1960s when this was the presidential palace of South Vietnam because you can see the things that they've added since then, like the communist flag and the statue of Ho Chi Minh. But I guess that's the point of reunification. I think this is the coolest room. This is where the National Security Council would meet. So the president, his national security advisors, US advisors, and then they still have all these maps that were used in the 60s and the 70s during the war. All the maps are just of South Vietnam to project and to track the trajectory of the war. Kind of cool.
Movies used to require a lot of technology.
Wow.
I don't know if you guys can read that, but it says, at 8:30 a.m. April 8th, 1975, First Lieutenant Pilot Nguyen Tan Trung flew FSE and threw down 2 bombs at the right target here. And supposedly that's the presidential helicopter.
Come on, we gotta go to the bunker.
The palace is main place to receive coded communication.
Yes, absolutely.
Enter easily. It is very small. So, as you can see, we got some coconuts. We're at the War Remnants Museum in Saigon / Ho Chi Minh. The tickets were $2 each, and it looks pretty sick. There's a lot of US Army planes and helicopters and other stuff, so we're gonna check it out.
Ngay từ đầu năm 1900.
And this one too.
We just finished up at the War Remnants Museum. That was a very somber and also depressing experience. This whole museum is focused on the American involvement in the war. And so we have, you know, American tanks, helicopters, troop carriers all out here. We didn't record a lot of the museum just because it's super unsettling, it's grotesque, the images of the gruesome horrors of war. But you definitely have to come and experience this if you're in Ho Chi Minh City, just to learn a bit about the history of what happened here. But it is obviously a bit one-sided in the same regard as the Hanoi Hilton was, but that's just how it is. That's how the telling of history is here.
try not to die. Time to go on Bui Vien Walking Street.
We're getting dinner. Before we head down to the street, I've yet to figure out how to pronounce it.
Howdy P, got some fried rice and I got some pho. And it looks like those are chilies and I need to get those out of there immediately.
This was formerly?
Anyway, thanks for watching the vlog, guys.
No, we're not ending it. We're going out and getting lit on Backpacker Street.
Oh.
How do you say it?
For all of those who've been eagerly anticipating my beer reviews from each country visit, this is my update I have for you. So this Saigon beer, number one. And subscribe so you don't ever miss my beer tasting reviews.